it's not just the 390 adventure that KTM has showcased in India. They've also showcased its bigger brother, the 790 adventure. The 390 does look hot, but this one is just a whole different beast. Now that is the same 799cc parallel twin motor that you get on the 790 Duke. But there is a little bit of difference because this one is making just 94 PS of power, but it still makes the same 88 Nm of torque. But more importantly, that torque comes in much lower at 6600 RPM. So in terms of riding off the road, this will definitely have a lot more punch.
These output figures might be similar to the BMW F850 GS and the current Tiger XCX. But it should be noted that Triumph has recently unveiled a new 900cc Tiger due next year that is likely to make in excess of 100 horsepower.
Speaking of going off the road, the 790 Adventure is packing quite a bit of kit. 200mm of travel on the rear suspension and 200 at the front as well, and 233mm of ground clearance. Now that's quite a lot. Unfortunately, the suspension isn't adjustable well, only for preload at the back. If you want fully adjustable suspension at both ends, well, for that you have the 790 Adventure R.
In terms of suspension travel, the 790 Adventure falls bang in the middle of the Tiger and the F850 GS, offering more than the Triumph, but little less than the BMW. To help its case off the road, the 790 Adventure runs on wire spoke wheels, 21 inches at the front and 18 at the rear, shod with Avon Trail Rider dual sport tires as standard. These though are not tubeless.
Now at 189 kilos of dry weight, this is not a featherweight bike by any means, and especially when you factor in that massive 20 litre fuel tank, you're gonna have a fairly high curb weight. But like rally bikes, this fuel tank goes all the way down on the motorcycles, which keeps the center of gravity really low, which is what you want when you're going off the road. At 850mm, this seat height is actually 5mm lower than that on the 390 Adventure, but it is running quite firm suspension at the back and the bike is a little bit wider as well. So with my height of 5'9", I'm pretty much on tippy toes on this motorcycle.
That seat height is actually a lot more compared to the likes of the Triumph Tiger XCX, but still lower than the BMW F850 GS.
Now, of course, being a KTM, you have plenty of electronic rider aids on board, and it gets the same one as you get on the 790 Duke. So you have multiple riding modes. The three basic ones are still there, that is rain, road, and sport. But instead of the track mode, this adventure gets an off-road mode, which is great for managing traction when you're riding on the loose stuff.
Cornering ABS and multi-level traction control is standard, of course. And optionally, you can also add a rally mode, which gives you on-the-fly control of the 9-level traction control.
And all this is controlled through a 6-axis IMU for that extra bit of control. Now, the one bit of kit that the Adventure doesn't get compared to the Duke is a quickshifter as standard.
The 790 Adventure offers a 5-inch color TFT screen that also supports Bluetooth connectivity using the KTM My Ride app for music, phone, and navigation control. Near the dash, it also gets a 12-volt socket and a GPS mount, along with a separate charger for your phone under the seat.
So is the 790 Adventure on the cards for India? Well, yes it is, but not as soon as you might think. Well, firstly because that motor is still Euro 4 compliant, not Euro 5, which means it's still not BS6 compliant, but KTM is working hard to get this engine certified for BS6, so it works well on the Duke as well as the Adventure. As for the timeline of this bike coming to India, we think sometime late 2020. Well, as for the price, expect that to be more than the Duke, somewhere in the region of about 10 to 11 lakhs ex-showroom. That puts it squarely against the likes of the BMW F850 GS in India.
Unlike its naked sibling, the 790 Duke, which is priced slightly higher than some of its competitors, we believe that the Adventure will manage to undercut its chief rivals. And that should be great news for fans of orange off-road bikes in India.